Well, my beloved, God bless your heart and your spirit, for this is the day that the Lord has made, and we are rejoicing in him, the God of our salvation. His goodness and mercy is flowing throughout the earth realm, and God is blessing his people. As he said in Joel, in the last days, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and daughters shall prophesy. And God is yet keeping his word. He is pouring out his spirit around the world, upon all flesh. We greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. This is your friend and brother, Apostle George B. in the beautiful city of Atlanta, Georgia, where it's 85 degrees here in the sunny city of Atlanta, which is the capital city of the state of Georgia. So we greet you. We speak the blessing of God upon your life, wherever you are around the world, and you're seeing this telecast. We speak the blessing of God upon you, upon your life, upon your health, upon your finances. We do decree and declare the blessings of the Lord, for the blessing of the Lord make it rich and added no sorrow with it. Well, we come to you every month, my beloved, to bring you a teaching from the word of God to encourage your heart, to build your faith in the word of the Lord. And in this month of the month of June 20 and 21, we're teaching on the word of God and freedom. Freedom. First of all, let's go to God in prayer. Eternal God, our Father, again, we thank you for your goodness, your love, your grace, and your mercy. As we beseech you at your throne, the grace God, send a fresh anointing, a fresh rhema word, a fresh power, and a fresh glory to speak to the hearts and the minds and the ears of the people. Open their hearts to receive. Open their eyes to see. Open their ears to hear. Or open their heart to the things of God. Now, Lord, we thank you for the supernatural manifestation in the lives of your people as they hear and receive this word in Jesus' name. Amen. Again, beloved, God bless your heart and your spirit as I share with you this teaching of June 20 and 21 is on freedom. For who the Son set free is free indeed, as the word of God declares over in the Gospel of John chapter 8, along verse 32. So we're talking about freedom. What does it mean to be free? Well, the word of God declares that Jesus Christ himself came to set the captives free. For we were a people that we were wrapped up, tied up, tangled up, messed up in sin. We was tore up from the floor up. We was in bondage. And we needed freedom that only a God from heaven could come and give us the freedom that we need. When Adam transgressed in the Garden of Eden, he fell from the things that God ordained Adam to do. When God created the garden over in Genesis, God told Adam, of every tree you can eat in the garden, but of this tree, of the tree of good and knowledge, do not eat of this tree. For the day you eat of this tree, you shall surely die. Well, in time, Adam was going on doing the things of God, trusting God, believing God. But then the time came where Adam disobeyed the command of God. And through Eve, he ate from the tree of good and evil. From then, sin as we know it came into the world, and mankind came into a fallen nature, and now mankind was in the bondage of sin. There was in the bondage of living under the foot of the devil and doing the things that the enemy, Satan, told them to do. Now they was living in bondage. But mankind needed a way of freedom to be free from the things of Satan. Even I recall over in concerning the book of Deuteronomy in the Old Testament, the Egyptians had enslaved the Hebrew people. And for 400 years, the people were enslaved in bondage to the Egyptians, where they had cried out to God because they knew it was not the will of God for them to be in slavery or bondage to no man. So the Bible said they cried out to God, God deliver us, God send us some help. And God healed the cries of the people. And God allowed a man named Moses to be born in the earth realm. But during that time, there was a decree that came out from the Pharaoh to kill all the male children, 2 years and younger. So in this season, Moses' mother knew she had to save her child. And she, on the way she could come to save him was to put him into a basket and put them in the sea that flow along the side into Pharaoh
Everywhere his sister would come and bathe every day. So the sister who had no children was praying to the gods of the Nile that one day they would give her a child. So on this appointed time, Moses' mother put Moses in a basket to save him from the decree that the Pharaoh had put out to kill all male child that was born 2 years and younger. As Pharaoh's sister was in the sea bathing, what comes up with this basket? And she hears this tears, just something crying. She goes to the basket, and lo and behold, look, it's a child. It's a male child. My prayers to the gods of the Nile have been answered. They have sent me a child. So she thought. But that was God's divine plan to secure the destiny and the purpose of Moses for the appointed time, which God would use him to go back and bring the Hebrew slaves out of bondage, out of Egypt, and from under the suppression of Pharaoh. So Pharaoh's sister took the child in as her own son, and she raised Moses right there under the nose of her brother, the Pharaoh, as her own son. And the Pharaoh received him as a grandson. So Moses was raised right in the enemy camp. But at the appointed time, God brought Moses out of Egypt and sent Moses into the wilderness to hear the voice of the Lord. As you read over in Exodus, the Bible said in Exodus chapter 3 that Moses was up in the mountain and he saw a burning bush. Now the bush was consumed with fire, but the bush did not burn. So it caught Moses' attention. So he went over towards the bush to see how is this bush is on fire but not being consumed. As Moses started going towards the bush, a voice spoke from the bush. It said, Moses, Moses, remove thy shoes from off thy feet, for the ground that you're standing on is holy ground. It was the voice of the living God, the voice that Moses was seeking to hear. And now Moses hears the voice of God for himself. Moses took his shoes off and knelt down in the presence of a holy God. And God started giving Moses instruction to go back to Egypt to bring my people out of bondage because I heard their cry. At the appointed time, when Moses came out of Egypt the first time from running from Pharaoh, he was 40 years of life. He spent 40 years in the wilderness listening to the instructions of God. At the age of 80, God now gave Moses instruction to go back to Egypt and tell Pharaoh, I said, let my people go because they was in bondage and it was never the will of God for you or the people of God to be in bondage. So God sent Moses after 40 years of training him in the wilderness to go tell Pharaoh to let my people go. When Moses first got there, Pharaoh did not want to receive the word of God. So as you read the account over in Exodus, God sent 10 different plagues unto Egypt before Pharaoh decided to let the people go. And the last plague that God sent to Egypt was the death of the firstborn. So when Pharaoh's son died, it broke the camel's back. He allowed the people to go with Moses, and now they're in the wilderness. Now they're in the wilderness going from Egypt to the promised land, which was only a 10-day journey. But because of their disobedience unto God and to God's instruction through Moses, they suffered for 40 years and walked around in circles for 40 years until the first generation died out and their children and their grandchildren went into the promise of the promised land because of their disobedience. Now, the word of God declares in Isaiah chapter 1, along verses 18 and 19, it says, if you are willing and obedient, you will eat the good of the land. It says over in the Gospel of John chapter 15 and 16, Jesus said, if you love me, keep my commandment, for obedience is better than sacrifice. So now I'm coming over to the New Testament. God had a plan for to get mankind back into the redemptive plan he had for them that Adam fell from. So at the appointed time, God sent a man called Jesus, who was God manifested in the flesh to redeem mankind, the souls of mankind, from under the bondage of Satan back into the plan of God for their lives. So after 400 years, Jesus came, God manifested in the flesh. It says over in Isaiah chapter 9, Isaiah was prophesying along verse 6. He said, unto you a child shall be born and a son shall be given, and you shall call his name Emmanuel, being interpreted God with us. In other words, God became flesh and came to dwell in the earth and with mankind. It says over in Gospel of John 1:1, it's declared, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. In other words, beloved, the Word is God, and God is the Word. And then it says over in verse number 14, it said, and that the Word became flesh and dwelt among us or upon mankind, and we beheld his glory, the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Now, Jesus' purpose was being born into the earth realm was to redeem mankind from under the bondage of Satan and back into the plan of God that God ordained for the lives before the foundation of the world. As I foresaid in the beginning, the word of God declares in John 8:32, for who the Son set free is free indeed. And Jesus came to set you and I free from sicknesses, from all manner of diseases, from bondage to alcohol, cocaine, any kind of drug, free from sexual sin, free from mental disorder, free from our physical disorders in our body. Jesus came to set us free from those bondages when we receive him as our Lord and our Savior and as our King. The Bible says in John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he sent or gave his only begotten Son, that was Jesus Christ, to come and save the world from their sin. But not only did Jesus come to save us from sin, he came to save us from the clutches of the devil. And a lot of people in the earth today, even people that are serving God, they're still in the clutches of the devil because they don't know all of the benefits that comes with salvation. For who the Son set free is free indeed. It declares in John 10:10, the Bible says, for the devil, which is Satan, cometh not but to steal, to kill, and destroy. But Jesus said, I have come, have his past tense, because he's already came. I have come that you and you and you might have life and have it more abundantly to the overflow, to it filled, and to it runs over in every area of your life, be it your health, be it your finances, be it your relationship, be it your marriage, your children, your grandchildren. Jesus came for you to have life abundantly in every area of your life. For those who the Son set free are free indeed. And if you don't know all the laws of the freedom that God gave you, they're found in the book called the Bible. In case you didn't know, I want to remind you, it's in the book called the Bible, which spells Bible, or it's an anagram for basic instruction before leaving earth. In the Bible, it's your manual, how God gives you instruction, how to live for him in the earth realm, so that he can give you all the blessing that he spoke to you concerning the word of God. The Bible said over in Corinthians 1:20, that all the blessings of God are yes and amen in him, because he came to set you free from every bondage. It is the will of God, according to 3 John 2, it is the will of God that you prosper, that you be in health, let me walk in divine health, in your physical body. He doesn't want any kind of ailment to be in divine health, and that your soul prosper. Because if your soul doesn't prosper through the word of God, then you cannot walk in divine health of your life, because you need to know that your soul needs to be restored through the word of God, because he wants to set you free, but you have to be set free in the mind of your spirit. Now, we're about to go into the freedom time. We'll be celebrating the month of July, what we call Independence Day. But Jesus gave you independence over 3,000 years ago for the independence of your soul, your spirit, and your body. So if you don't know the contract that he gave you according to the word of God, you can live in the earth as a believer, but yet be in bondage and not live in the freedom that Christ died on the cross to redeem you. That's entitled to you. It's a benefit for you being a child, a son, or daughter of God. So believe, my friend, receive and believe all that God has ordained for you, that Christ died on the cross for you to have. Now, I want to share with you, beloved, from the word of God. It says in Psalms, verse 107, chapter 107 and verse 20, it declared that God said, I sent my word. Sin is past tense. God said, I sent my word to heal them and deliver them from all their destruction. The word has already come through Jesus Christ to heal you, to save you, to deliver you, to prosper you. But you must know what God has said about your life concerning the word. That is your contract with heaven, is the Bible. Because in the word of God is all the things that God has ordained for you in the Garden of Eden, and wherever you live in, you live in Africa, South America, New York, New Jersey, Arizona, California, wherever, Virginia, North Carolina, South Carolina, Georgia, where I'm located, Illinois, Tennessee, it doesn't matter where you're at. If you're a believer in Christ Jesus, the one that died for you on the cross, if you have made him your Lord and Savior, he's the King of kings and Lord of lords. All these benefits belong to you. But Satan, your adversary, the devil, don't want you to know these things. But here I am as a man of God, sharing with you the word of the Lord. It says in John 6:63, for the words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. They are life-changing words that will change your atmosphere. It will change your situation by you speaking the word of God. The Bible says in Genesis chapter 1 that God said, let there be light, and there was light. God said, let there be fowls in the air. There was fowls in the air. God said, let there be fish in the sea. There was fish in the sea. God said, let there be a firmament between heaven and the earth, and there was a firmament between the heaven and the earth. God said, let there be vegetable and trees. Everything that God said, he spoke words, and the words that he spoke came into manifestation. Well, when Jesus came at the appointed time, he was now God manifested in the flesh. And when you read through the New Testament between Mark, Matthew, Luke, and even to Acts, everything that Jesus said, he spoke words. He spoke to a storm over in the Gospel of Mark chapters 4 and 5. He spoke to the storm, and the storm, he said, peace, be still, and the storm stopped. He spoke to a man that was called Legion, living in the cemetery, because he was full of demons. He told the demons to come out, and they came out at the words that he spoke. And the man was amazed because the demons came out at the power of the words that he spoke. Well, my beloved, because you are a believer in Christ Jesus, you receive his spirit, you have his word, you are baptized in the Holy Ghost, you have the same authority to speak words of freedom to your situation, to your family situation, to your community, to your neighborhood, to your city, to your state, to your local church. Wherever you go, you have the freedom and the authority of God to speak freedom to every situation. How do I know that? Because the Bible says in John 14 and 12, believe me for the very work's sake, said Jesus, for these things that I do, shall you, the believer, do also. Because that's what the word declares. And the word of God declares in Isaiah 55 that the word of God cannot return void, but it must and it will accomplish the purposes it's spoken and sent to do. And then it's going to prosper unto the things where that word was sent. Now, beloved, you have been freed by the power of God. You have been freed by the Holy Spirit. You've been baptized and empowered by the Holy Ghost. You've been instructed through the word of the living God. Now go forth in the earth realm, wherever God sends you, and set the captives free. You've been given the authority of God. You've been given the word of the Lord. You've been given Jesus Christ as the captain of your life. And you've been given the baptism, which is the power of the Holy Ghost. For it says in Acts 1 and 8, but you, that's right, my beloved, my dear friend, my brother, and my sister, you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and you shall go forth and walk in supernatural miracles, signs, and wonders, setting the captives free from the hand of the enemy. Now, the enemy does not care who he hold captive. He want to keep them held captive until the day they leave the earth realm. But it is not the will of God that in a man or woman or child should be lost, but they should come to the saving knowledge of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. Beloved, the Bible says over in Romans 10 that if you will confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus Christ and believe in your heart that God raised Jesus from the dead, that thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. You see, to be saved, you got to say something. To be free, you got to say something. To be prosperous, you got to say something. To be healed, you got to say something. There was a man that was sick over in Matthew chapter 8, along verse 5. There was a centurion that had a servant that was at home, sick unto death. And he came to Jesus. And Jesus said, I will go home with you and heal him. But the centurion said to Jesus, no, you don't need to come to my home or under my roof. I understand that you have authority. If you just open your mouth and say something, speak the word, I know my servant shall be made whole. And Jesus just spoke the word, wherever that man was, in California, North Carolina, Africa, New Australia, New Zealand, it did not matter. He was healed by the spoken word. So my beloved, even today, I speak over your life for you to be healed of any kind of sickness in your body, heart condition, lung condition, kidney disease, arthritis, leukemia, sickle cell, cancer, AIDS. Right now, I send the word through the airways to heal your body, to give you freedom in that area of your life. If you need salvation, I pray with you the sinner's prayer. Pray that prayer, and the Lord will save you right now. If you need to be prosperous, start speaking to your finances. Start speaking to your pocketbook. Start speaking to your wallet. Because understand, beloved, the Bible says it is God's good pleasure to give us the kingdom. The Bible says in Psalm 37:4, delight thyself in the Lord, and I will give you the desires of your heart. So as you do the things that pleases God, God will give you things. He didn't say you will buy them. He didn't say you the contract for them. He didn't say you will make a payment on them. He said, I will give them to you. Someone just gave me a truck 2 years ago. They gave me a 2004 Liberty Red. He came up to me and said, man of God, God told me to give you this truck. He'll go to title deed. He'll go to the keys. Go put it in your name. I was given a laptop back in the month of April 2021, a Mac Pro laptop made by Apple. I was given an iPhone in this month, May of 2021, iPhone made by Apple. Delight thyself in the Lord, and he will give you the desires of your heart. Even, beloved, as you sense this anointing, as you sense the glory of God come into your atmosphere, whatever situation you need freedom in, speak the word of the Lord. And I bless God now for the word going through the airways, because your life's going to be changed when you receive the anointing on this word and the glory of God into your atmosphere. So I release the anointing of God to your situation and the glory into your atmosphere for you to be delivered, to be healed, and be set free from any bondage that you're in right now. Again, this is Pastor George Reed coming to you from Atlanta, Georgia, by way of Piercing the Darkness Deliverance Ministry, by way of Viage Care, by way of the CEO and the founder, Kalinzia Pett. I want to thank her love for the opportunity to sit here in front of this computer and share with you the word of God to bring freedom in your life. Beloved, I bless God again for you and for his word teaching you on this day. If you want to be a blessing to my life and to my ministry, my cash app is $PeterPaul7. $PeterPaul7. You want to share a love gift with me, I'm very much appreciative. I'm not asking for you for anything for the word, because the word comes with freedom. But beloved, be free on this day. I bless you in the name of the Lord. Until we speak again, be healed, be delivered, and be set free in Jesus' name. God bless your heart, beloved.